This Paul Rashad, she's a graduate student with a bachelor's degree in dental surgery and is currently working towards a master's in, of science degree in healthcare management from Cal State University, Los Angeles. So that's a pretty important thing. Professor London is a professor of public health at Cal State University, Los Angeles. Not too surprising there. A co-author of the college textbook Consumer Health, A Guide to Intelligent Decisions. He's also the associate editor of Quackwatch's free weekly newsletter, which I'm not sure he's attracting, but maybe he should. And he's also an online columnist for Skeptical Inquirer. So today, it's interesting that this theme of naturopathy has been kind of current one in the whole conference. We made these selections long ago, so it's great that they kind of reinforced. So if I'll please bring on stage, Professor London.
Promoted on the websites of the licensed naturopath doctors in Los Angeles County. So the first thing is, what is naturopathy? I think Brett has already told you about it. And the question lies is, what is Aberrant about it? There are 19 US states which are registered for the naturopaths, 5 Canadian provinces, District of Columbia, Puerto Rico, and US Virgin Islands. So alternative, complementary, and integrated, they are just euphemisms. And what are Aberrant about this is that they have Aberrant notion of underlying causes of diseases. They have aberrant notions of what should be considered diseases, and they have aberrant methods of screening, diagnosis, prevention, interventions, and health maintenance. So the question lies, to the what extent is the aberrant healthcare in the mainstream within the naturopathy? So let me take you to some background of the aberrant nature of the naturopaths. So in 1968, the US Department of the Health, Education, and Welfare, they recommended against the Medicare coverage of naturopaths. They concluded that their theory and their practice is not based upon the body of the basic knowledge related to the health, disease, and the healthcare, which has been widely accepted now. In 2016, the past weeks, they have reported that nearly half a dozen of 300 Toronto naturopaths within the online, they have breached the advertisement standards by making false claims and misleading healing claims for their services. In June 20, 2017, Tim Caulfield, they have examined 330 naturopaths websites in Alberta, and Manitoba, and they found out that 40 included the vaccine hesitance and 26 were offered the alternatives for vaccines. So let me take you to our neighborhood. In April 2017, San Diego medical examiner, they have confirmed that the 30-year-old Jack Edrick was killed by the intravenous turmeric solution administered by the California naturopath doctor who advertised this non-validating treatment on this website. So until January 1st, 2018, there was a Naturopathic Doctor Act. So because of the bill, because of the Senate Bill 796, it has been moved and it's going to be repealed and reviewed to the January 1st, 2022. So because of this bill, it is going to, the naturopathic practice is going to be legalized for next 5 years. So what methods which we did? So we took the name and the address of 127 naturopathic were based on the Los Angeles, and they have an active license, and they were identified by using the California Department of Consumer Affairs Breeze online database. And the Google search were done on their names, and their 33 clinical websites were found out of the 127 naturopaths. So websites were reviewed, and the Aberrant services were tabulated. So what were the findings? So on clinical persons, there were 33 naturopaths having the website, but some were working together and some were working solo. Thus, a total of 28 clinical websites were reviewed for the 33 identified ND from the Breeze database. And 28 clinical websites were reviewed, and they were staffed with 42 naturopaths. So the question lies, what percentage of 28 websites promoted the Aberrant services? And the answer was 100%. So the top 10 most confirmed advertisements Aberrant services, and the first one was the bioidentical hormone replacement, herbal medicine, homeopathy, intravenous nutrient infusion, intramuscular nutrient injections, chelation, functional medicine, and HCC or the other shots for the weight loss, blood testing for the food allergy and sensitivity. And there were some of the other advertisements for the Aberrant services, and there were like prolotherapy, adrenal fatigue, platelet-rich plasma, they have alternative vaccine schedule, chakra balancing, cupping, gemstone and crystal healing.
Oh my God.
They have healing touch therapies, they have visceral manipulation, they have Reiki, and they have Shih Tzu and many
Shih Tzu.
And the services not categorized as Aberrant, they were diet counseling, gynecological examination, stress management, and wellness examination and physical examination. They had well child check, osteopathic or the naturopathic manual medicine, and so on. So in the conclusion, I would like to say that Aberrant Healthcare is in the mainstream within the naturopathy for the Los Angeles County. We cannot categorize on the statistical grounds to the other California counties. Nevertheless, it would be surprising if there were markedly less Aberrant services among the naturopaths outside the Los Angeles County. The standard of practice are meaningless within the pseudo medicine, and naturopathy is a pseudo medicine. So, just about any good physician assistant who is not practicing pseudo medicine can perform the work of the naturopath. And pseudo medicine should not be licensed in any state, territory, district, or any provinces. Thank you.
So this may have been her first presentation, so another round of applause, please.